Okay, here we go, the Transformers explosion cake. First, we'll start with the letters. So I'll use a template to cut out all the middle grey part first. And then, as you can see, to make it look sort of 3D, I'm gonna put it on the black background. Just putting a bit of water on the back of the letter, sticking it onto the black fondant, and then just sort of roughly chopping around the sides. And then just really delicately trying to cut around, just leaving about a millimeter, 2 millimeters around the edge of the gray letter, just so it kind of looks like it's got a shadow, you know, kind of like the actual newer Transformer letter colors. So we've got gray, which will eventually be a little bit silvery, and because we might paint him after, and with the nice rounded black edge. Okay, now the symbol. So this is the Autobot symbol, for Optimus Prime, all the good guys anyway. So I've got a little template, tried to cut it out by keeping the actual template intact so I can just sort of position it in the right spot. So again, just a little bit of water on the back of the pieces. I'm going to pop them on in the right spot and just carefully sort of pull the paper off so they're just basically in the right spot. Now I'm just gonna kind of align them up a bit better so they look perfect. So yeah, just with the knife, the tip of the knife, trying to put them in the right spot so it just looks as good as it can. Okay, now that it's in the right spot, we're going to cut just around again, leaving about 2 millimeters this time because I want to have a nice sort of thicker border, just nice and neat all the way around, tapping sort of the edges so they're a bit smoother, and that's pretty much it. And that is the Decepticon symbol that I made a bit earlier, so there's my letters. Onto the cake. So I baked 3 20-centimeter chocolate cakes and leveled them all off, cut them all in half, so I have 6 equal layers. For this first Optimus Prime cake, it's going to be 4 layers. So cake, cream, cake, cream, cake, cream, cake. And I've got red and blue cream because it's for Optimus Prime. The cream I'm using is Mascarpone cream. And so I've dyed 2/3 red and 1/3 blue just to alternate the colours. And then just sort of smoothing off the edges, just really roughly now because it's not very firm, so I'm going to put it in the fridge just to firm up and just make it easier to spread the buttercream around after. And for my bumblebee cake, I just it's going to be 2 layers, so I dyed the other bit of cream yellow for bumblebee because the cake is chocolate, it's kind of dark anyway, so no need for black, so kind of black and yellow anyway. And yeah, just again smoothing out the edges, I'm going to just put them in the fridge to chill for a minute. Now this is my base cake, so it's actually 40 centimeters, so it's really big. And now I've dyed the rest of my cream sort of a purpley greyish sort of color, so kind of like Megatron, a bit evil. Anyway, I'm putting chocolate chips in this bottom layer and then just again stacking it all up. So it's a really big cake, so it kind of does help if you chill it a little bit first, just makes it a bit easier to pick up and place. So again, cake layer, cake layer. This is 3 layers in this one, so we've got 3 cakes and 3 different heights. This one is 3 layers, Optimus is 4 layers because it's going to be bigger, and Bumblebee is 2 layers, so you can kind of see the difference in heights. That's it, just spreading around the cream, putting the other top on, and again chilling it just before I put the buttercream around the edge so we can cover it in fondant. now crumb coated and chilled the cakes. Again, another just a neat, really thin layer of buttercream ready to go to cover the cake. So it's an explosion cake. So first I need to cut out two circles of an alternate color. So I'm using red for this one. This is Optimus cake again, just sort of kneading out the edges. Now we need two because one's going to cover the buttercream and one's going to be actually opening. So you will see the contrast from the blue and the red in the cake. So popping them both on, smoothing it out. I've just put a bit of cornstarch in the middle just so they don't stick. So when I cut it open, they're not going to stick. So we're covering this cake in blue. So rolling out the blue fondant, just big enough to cover the entire cake, covering it over. So we've got to sort of smooth out the edges, pull in and tuck it all in, make it nice and neat, cut off the excess and just sort of get it nice and flush with the cake. Doesn't matter too much if there's a bit of tearing or anything. I'm going to actually put decorations around the edge, so we've got some red flames, so it doesn't matter too much. If there's a bit of tearing, we're going to fix that up with a paste after as well. So smooth out everything and cut it nice and flush with the cake. So now it's time to cut our explosion part. So I'm just going to divide it into 8 pieces. So in half again, just sort of marking it off with a nice little ruler first. And gonna sort of cut through so I can kind of just get the two layers. So I've got the blue and the red. Actually gonna get some water to stick those two together. So kind of cutting them in quarters and then just putting a bit of water to stick it all together. Just kind of rub out the edges so it doesn't look too rough, so they're nice and smooth. And just the same with all 8 peaks. Going to glue down the tips of them with just a little bit of water onto the outside. Now we're just going to fix those tears. You can't really see me mixing, but mixing some of the blue fondant with some water, just mixing it all up till it's kind of liquidy. And just with a little spatula, I'm going to put it in all those little tears. You can just see around the top edge of the cake, and there was a little hole on the other side. Doesn't matter too much because it's going to be covered anyway, so you're not really going to see it too much, but just to make it look a bit more nice and professional. Bumblebee cake, doing the same thing. I just thought it might be easier to put the water on first, so before I put the yellow fondant on top, I'm just going to put a bit of water on the black circle so it's going to stick to it, just going to make it a little bit easier to cut out the section after. So same thing, spreading out the cake, cutting off the excess, just making it nice and neat. The little tears will fix up in a minute, the same as we did with the blue one. And smoothing out the edges so we can cut out this explosion too. So same thing for the explosion, just cutting out the section, so in quarters and then in half again. So we've got 8 pieces, just mark out and then cut a bit deeper, so a really nice sharp knife is good. Cutting out, smoothing edges and rolling them back. Okay, now for my base cake, I've just measured out sort of where the two top cakes are going and positioned my two little purple circles. So this explosion is going to be a little bit smaller, but just putting in the right spot, the same as the other two cakes. Should be an expert by now, you've done two. Put a bit of water on the purple top circle just so it sticks a bit better to the grey, as you saw it was easier to cut it out that way. Cover the cake, cut up the excess, make it nice and neat. And you can see where the circle is, so don't worry about losing it or anything because it's that bit thicker because there's two layers under there, and you know exactly where to cut it. This explosion, I'm actually going to place the cakes first because it is sort of a small surface. So I need to know where I can actually fold out those flaps. So I've folded out the first four, just in the front because they're not touching anything. Then placing my two cakes. So I've got my bumblebee cake with the two black lines. There's my Optimus cake with the red flames. Now I'm just going to open out each of the other four back flaps so they'll actually be touching the cake. Just again with a bit of water, sticking them on in their spots. Okay, we're ready to go. This is the last and my favorite step. Just putting everything on the cake. So I've got my symbols, Decepticons, and the Autobots. I've got my letters. These are my awesome people, or bots, I should say. First we've got Bumblebee, so I've made them all pre-hand, so they're all dried and they're a bit hard. With like a lollipop stick down the middle, sort of fixing it on the actual cake. So I've got his body, his head, and then I've stuck in everything with toothpicks. So he's got his arms and his wheel parts that are all separate, and then I've stuck in his doors in the back, so his wings, so they're all sort of stuck in. If you have to just sort of move the explosion part a bit to fit him in, same with Optimus. So again, head, body, arms, everything is all separate pieces because they're just sitting in the cake with toothpicks. And indeed, I had to open a lot more Optimus because he was really big, but it's alright because it's an explosion, doesn't have to be even. Just pull it all out, let him sit in, make him fit. And of course we've got Megatron in the front, so I've painted him all silver as well. So again, same thing, stick with his head, a little bit evil there, and popped him in the cake. He's got one arm in the cake and one sort of sitting on the cake like he's just about to come out. Now I've put some little balls to sort of look like rubble, I guess, like one that while they're coming out. And the last step of course was some stars. So what's an explosion cake without actual explosion and exploding stars? Pop them sort of in right at the last minute just to see sort of where they're going to be sitting. A giant four because it is my son's fourth birthday. And this is the final Transformers cake. There he is. So we've got Optimus, Bumblebee, Megatron, got the little Decepticon and my Autobot symbols, and of course the letters, which I did give him a bit of a brush with some silver luster dust, I guess, so they can look nice and metal-y. And that's it. There's my cake. There's the slice of the cake. So you can see the blue and red cream and the purple cream and the yellow one, which I didn't have a photo. But yeah, that's it. Thanks everyone for watching. And I've got some links down below to the How to Cake It site because she's just really awesome and I use her recipes. Thank you.